मेजरमेंट ऑफ बेरिंग। द बेरिंग आर मेजर इन द फॉलोइंग टू सिस्टम। फर्स्ट वन इज अ होल सर्कल बेरिंग सिस्टम WCB। एंड वॉट इज होल सर्कल बेरिंग? द बेरिंग ऑफ अ लाइन मेजर विथ अ रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ मैग्नेटिक मेरिडियन इन अ क्लॉक वाइज डायरेक्शन इज कॉल्ड मैग्नेटिक बेरिंग एंड इट्स वैल्यू वेरीज बिटवीन 0 to 360 degree। You can see in a figure, the coordinates start from the north and progress in a clockwise direction as the first coordinate is 0 to 90 degree in a clockwise direction. Second coordinate is between 90 degree to 180 degree. Third coordinate is between 180 degree to 270 degree. And fourth coordinate is between 270 degree to 360 degree. Okay, in a figure, A, B, C and D station fall in A station falls in a first coordinate, B station is fall in a second coordinate, third C station is fall in third coordinate, and D station fall in fourth coordinate. Okay, so the whole circle bearing of a line is angle of that line from the given north direction in a clockwise direction. Okay, so here theta 1 is equal to, if it is 45 degree, theta 2 is equal to 150 degree, theta 3 is equal to 210 degree, and theta 4 is equal to 340 degree. Okay, so how you write that in a hole bearing system? Okay, so line OA means theta 1, okay, is equal to theta 1 and is equal to 45 degree. Okay, for line OB is equal to theta 2 and is equal to 150 degree in a whole circle bearing system. Same as for third coordinate and a fourth coordinate for 210 degree and 204 degree. Okay. Prismatic compass is used to measure bearing of a line in a whole circle system. Okay, so prismatic compass are used to measure the bearing of a line in the whole circle bearing system. Okay, there is a prismatic compass, the range is between 0 to 360 degree in a prismatic compass. Okay, next one is reduced bearing system. Okay, in this system the bearing of survey line are measured with respect to north line or south line, whichever is the nearest to the given survey line, and either in the clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Okay, in a figure you can see that first coordinate, this is your first coordinate, is north and east. Your second coordinate is between south to east, and third coordinate is south to west, and fourth coordinate is north to west. Okay, so now coordinate is defined with respect to north direction and south, whichever is nearest to the angle. When the whole circle bearing of a line is converted into coordinate bearing, it is termed as reduced bearing. Okay, now we convert whole circle bearing into the reduced bearing. Okay, so the value is varies between 0 to 90 degree. In a whole circle bearing, the range of bearing is between 0 to 360 degree. But in reduced bearing, it is a 0 to 90 degree. Okay, and The surveyor compass measure the bearing line of cordon system, okay, or radius bearing system. In a radius bearing system, the value lies between 0 to 90 degree with a proper designation or proper direction, like theta 1 is in a first quadrant, approximate is a 45 degree, assume. So how you write? So theta 1 is equal to, okay, write north 45 degree towards east, okay. This is your radius bearing of theta A. For theta B, okay, 150 degree, assume. Then how you write for theta 2? So it is south. Okay, now we need to calculate. So 180 minus 150 is 30 degree towards the east. So this angle is 30 degree from south. Okay, so south 30 degree towards east. So this is type of the radius bearing. Okay, now same as for the theta 2, theta 3 and theta 4. Calculate yourself. Okay, 195 degree not into radius bearing. Now for the converting from whole circle bearing to radius bearing, there is a four equation. Okay, if the whole circle bearing, means bearing, is in a first quadrant, means is range between 0 to 90 degree, use that equation is RB is equal to WCB and the quadrant is northeast. If the bearing is in a second quadrant, means it is between 90 to 180 degree, then use the equation RB is equal to 180 degree minus WCB and the quadrant is south to east. For the third quadrant, the bearing is between 180 degree to 270 degree. Use the equation RB is equal to WCB minus 180 degree and the quadrant is south to east. Same as for the fourth quadrant, and the bearing is between 270 to 360 degree. Use that equation is RB is equal to 360 minus WCB and the quadrant is northwest. Okay, so now for example, take a WCB is equal to 49 degree. So now WCB is 49 degree, means angle is between 0 to 90 degree, means it is in a first quadrant. Okay, so from the above table, the RB is equal to WCB. So what is WCB? It's 49 degree. So that is your answer. So 240 degree is in a third quadrant. Okay, the value between 180 degree to 270 degree. Okay, so it is in a third quadrant. Okay, so equation used for RB is equal to WCB minus 180 degree. So write 240 minus 1. So RB is equal to WCB minus 180 because it is in a third quadrant. So write 240 minus 180 degree, it is 60 degree. Now in a radius bearing, we use north direction and a south direction. So it is in a third quadrant. Okay, so this is the third quadrant. This is north, okay, south, east and west. So 240 is a between here, 60 degree, somewhere here. How you write? So south, from south 60 degree towards west. Okay, so how you write? This is the correct way to write in a radius bearing system. Okay, same as in above example, it is in first quadrant for a 49 degree, okay, north towards it. So how you write north, from north 49 degree towards east. So this is the correct way write in a reduced bearing system. Okay, now calculate yourself. For a WCB is equal to 133 degree and 335 degree. First, what you do? First, find the quadrant. This bearing is fall in which quadrant? Based on that, you use above equation, one of four equation. Okay, and select quadrant. Which quadrant are used to represent that value RB? Okay, reduced bearing, and then put a answer. Okay, after converting in a reduced bearing.